To a new video. This is kind of an unnecessary video, but since I'm kind of still testing my new studio setup, I decided today to do an unboxing of a new lens I finally got, which has been reviewed many times, so there's probably nothing new that you will see here, but I figured let's do an unboxing of it. And it's from the Nice 1.4 GM Sony prime lens. So here we go, let's unbox this. I've never done an unboxing video, so that's the first time of me doing that, but it's also a little bit to test the whole setup. So yeah, of course there's the packaging over here, as you can see, and all of the GM lenses come with in this sort of pouch, which personally I never use. Once I get it out, so I have a whole bunch of them, and that was the box. So the box can now go somewhere else. Let me put it over there. Then you can see there's this nice pouch that they give you. I normally never use it, to be fair. So by the end, I normally leave it in the box so that if I want to resell it, I can still do that. And in this pouch, they normally do this zipper sort of construction. And again, this is probably not the first, by far not the first unboxing video. So there is the lens. All right, let's put it over there. And you will find also inside the cap. And then we have the box, which is a nice looking sort of thing. But I will not use it. So what I will do, no, there's also a strap in there. Sorry, didn't see that. There's the strap for the carrying bag, which I also don't use. So I will put them back. What I normally do is take the lens cap material off. I always use my hood. Oh, it's nice and velvety, velvet inside. And it also has this new lock, which some of the new Sony's have. I like them a lot. It's a pity that they have not been doing that for years, because now you sometimes get confused when you're depending on your lens. You sort of try to press the button, or you forget to press the button, and you might hurt the lens or the hood. Let's take it out of its plastic bag. And there we have the two victims of today. So, yeah, what I normally do is put all the wrappings back into the box and keep the box in a safe place. So that's what I'm doing now. Put it on the stack where all the others are. So if I need to resell it, or once I resell it, I have the box, and it keeps the value up. Okay, so there we have the lens. And I think the first thing before we put it on, I think what's interesting to see is how it compares to other lenses of the same type. So let me put the hood on. So there it is, top view. And I decided to get, which of course is smaller, but I am still impressed how small this actually is. So let's go to the side view. Then it's probably, but this is the 1.4 Sigma 30 millimeters for APS-C. And here you have the 1.4 full frame. I guess it's about 1.5 times bigger, which kind of makes sense, right? So if you see it from this side, but this is a full frame version, and this, of course, is not. I'm already impressed with how small it is for a 1.4 lens. So let's get a camera and hook it up. So here we have an A7 R3, which now has a 55 millimeters 1.8 on it. Which I actually, I know that many people love this lens. It's not that I dislike it, it's not that I'm totally against this lens, but it's not my favorite lens. So yeah, that's kind of it. So let's put a 24 on it, and I'm suspecting that will be a much more of a favorite of mine, especially on the A7 R3, because there, of course, we can also go into crop mode, so it can kind of do, yeah, dual duty in a way. So let's change the lens and put it on for the first time. Where's the dot? There is the dot. Ooh, it's quite heavy to put on. Let me also show you a trick which I've, well, wouldn't say it's a trick, but sometimes I'm surprised that people don't notice this. Let's go to the top camera. Just a simple sort of trick. When you're putting on a Sony lens, and this is actually going on quite heavily. So the first few times, because of the weather sealing, that the dot which is over here, if you align it with the dot over here on your camera, so this dot, I still need to work a little bit on the camera position. But like I said, I'm also trying to figure out, you see that these two dots align. I hope that makes sense what I'm saying. So this dot actually is now aligned kind of with the marker, which is on top of your camera. So you kind of know where to put it. It locks in quite heavily because of the weather sealing. So it's on. I guess probably a good idea to take the lens cap off. And let's turn it on. And it works. It gives me a picture. So that's very cool. Turn it back off again. And so there we have the 1.4. And you can see basically how small it is. It's quite nice. Has a nice feeling to it. It's very small for what it is. Yeah, so we have the aperture ring over here, which has an automatic and a manual one, which is nice. Not sure how many times I by accident will put it in f16 if I don't want to, but it has a de-clicking mechanism over here that you can turn on and off. So if you turn it off, it will not. Now it's really smooth for video, and if you turn it on, it will have the clicky, which is nice. I think on the other side it also has a yep, an AF on MF button. That's nice. And one of my favorite buttons on the Sony lenses, the programmable button on the side of your lens. That's kind of it. Not much more to say about it. I think it's going to be a happy marriage. Yeah, if you already have seen this many times in videos, I'm pretty sure this is not the first time you have seen it. But if you by accident run into this video first, at least you have seen an unboxing and how it sort of fits on this A7 R3. So thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Bye bye.